Now we are working the latest developments on the state budget. Right now, the Senate Finance Committee is taking up the $8.1 billion plan that House lawmakers passed last night. They approved imposing a tax on taxi rides, luxury clothing, and dog grooming. But they did not pass a new tax on the governor strongly supported. From the Providence Mobile Newsroom, Eyewitness News reporter Sean Daly is in the capital city.
At the end of a long few weeks here at the State House, a budget is near for next year.
Among the many proposals for Rhode Island's $8.1 billion budget, Governor Lincoln Chafee's idea to raise the tax restaurants charge their diners. It's now at 8%, and that's where it will stay. No hike, thanks to rising revenues from sales taxes and income taxes.
Our revenues are much higher. That's good news for Rhode Island.
That's the kind of loss you can take.
Yes, that's a good situation where income tax revenue, sales tax revenue are higher than when I put in my budget.
The governor says he was hoping tax revenues would rise, just not counting on it.
I foresaw that there was a possibility of better revenue numbers.
As an intense few weeks here at the State House draw to a close, Eyewitness News got a rare glimpse at the pressure some of Rhode Island's leaders operate under. In a poignant moment, Speaker of the House Gordon Fox revealed all the responsibilities can be overwhelming at times.
Right now, I've got tax policy on my brain. I've got a budget on my brain. You're asking me very complicated questions, and guess what? I am not a machine. I am not a machine, and everyone expects me to be, but I'm not a machine.
The full House passed next year's budget early this morning after 11 hours of debate. The full Senate is expected to vote early next week. At the State House with the Providence Mobile Newsroom, Sean Daly, Eyewitness News.